Savior, I come, quiet my soul. Remember, redemption's hill, where your blood was spilled for my ransom. Everything I once held dear, I count it all as lost. Lead me to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Rid me of myself, I belong to you. Oh, lead me. Lead me to the cross. You were as I, tempted and trialed. You were, Word became flesh, bore my sin and death. Now you're risen. Everything I once held, I count it all as lost. Lead me to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Rid me of myself, I belong to you. Only
let's talk about these for a bit, shall we? Does talking about death and sin make you uncomfortable? I'm sorry. And I know I'm stepping into controversial territory with this, but hey, who knows how much time we have left? Do you? We've heard about this man named Jesus. People say he's God and he died for us. Why did he die? He died to save us. More specifically, to save us from sin. But this much, many of us have heard at some point in our lives. But how many of us really know what that means? And what is this sin anyway? I mean, I live a moral life. Sure, I've had a bad past. And occasionally, I still go back to my bad habits, sure. But I mean, on a day-to-day basis, I think I do enough to right my wrongs. So I'm okay, right? Wrong. The wages of sin is death. Many of us have heard that. But how many of us know that morality does not erase sin? Because sin is bigger than moral signs. Sin causes separation between us and God. And separation from God is death. So why am I not dead now? Someone I know once said that death by separation from God is like switching off a fan. It doesn't stop instantly, but it has been cut off from electricity supply. So if I'm a sinner and my body is still running, I am that fan that's slowing down. So what about those who've been saved by Jesus? I've seen them die. Well, you've seen their bodies die. Their souls are still saved. So what? The souls of those who've not been saved stop existing once their bodies are dead? No. Things would have been much different if that's how it was. The wages of sin is death. And there's a whole world beyond the tangible, physical world that we see and comprehend. This world's not forever. But the one beyond this is for eternity. We all have souls. And those souls will either be with God in heaven forever or face eternal death in hell. And you can say you don't want to choose sides, because living a life following God is too difficult. I'll be a nice person, I'm not gonna harm anyone else, but I want to live my life the way I want. Let me tell you something. Eternal life with God and eternal death are mutually exclusive. If you don't choose the former, you choose the latter by default. There is no in between. And I wish there was another way, because that would make things so much easier. But Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." If there was another way, Jesus would not have needed to come and die on the cross to save us from this eternal death. But there is no other way. And Jesus had to come down as a human to suffer and die for the redemption of humankind once and for all. But if he died and saved me, isn't that all that's needed to be done? No. Death formed a gap between us and God, and God bridged that gap through Jesus when he died on the cross. But the choice to take that bridge still needs to be made, and that choice is yours. You and I are not saved till we choose that bridge. I know it's politically correct to say that all ways are true and that all ways lead to the same destination. But Jesus says there is only one way. And I know you're not gonna like this if this is not what you believe in. It is hard to hear, and it's even harder to say. Our world's come to a halt by a virus right now. Everyone's frantically trying to find a vaccine. The vaccine. Because we know it's not going to be cured by a flu shot, or by Ayurveda, or even chemotherapy. Aren't they all medicines? But we know that we need a specific solution that is directed at curing coronavirus. And if we're so bothered by not having the answer to a problem that is of a world we're not going to be in forever, why aren't we just as bothered about a problem that we will have to deal with in a life that will last forever? Maybe some of us think that we'll deal with the problems of this world when we're in this world, and we'll deal with the matters of the afterlife after this life. But that's the thing. You can't buy a plane ticket after you get on the plane. You need to get it before that. Do you know when your plane is gonna leave? Do you know if you have time to live your life before you buy the plane ticket? Before you choose to take the bridge away from death? The wages of sin is death. And time is ticking.